In the beginning, God created the world, and he created Adam, the first man ever, and his wife Eve, the first woman. God gave Adam dominion over the fishes of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all of the earth. Adam was the most powerful man at that time. Eve was considered the mother of all people. They were like the king and queen of the earth. Adam lived for 930 years. People lived for a really, really long time. Adam and Eve had many sons and many daughters. After Cain killed his brother Abel, Cain went out from the presence of the Lord, and he went moving and wandering in the land toward the east of Eden. Years passed, and Cain had a son, and he called his name Enoch. And at that time, Cain also began to build a city. And he built the city, and he called the name of the city Enoch, according to the name of his son. For in those days the Lord had given him rest upon the earth, and he did not move about and wander as in the beginning. Adam and Eve had many sons and many daughters. One of their sons, Seth, had a son named Enosh, saying, "Because in that time the sons of men began to multiply and to afflict their souls and hearts by disobeying and rebelling against God." Some of the sons of God, also known as angels or divine beings, wanted human wives. These sons of God, also known as the fallen angels, did something wrong by marrying human women. This led to the birth of special and powerful beings called the Nephilim. But because of this and the wickedness spreading among people, God was very angry. The children of the fallen ones became giants in the earth in those days. The same became mighty men, which were of old men of renown and also known as demigods. Nephilim came in all different species. Some became dreadful and destructive beasts. They were called dinosaurs. And the sons of men went and they served other gods. And they forgot the Lord who had created them in the earth. And in those days, the sons of men made images of brass and iron, wood and stone, and they bowed down and served them. And some of the sons of men caused their wives to drink a poisonous potion that would stop them from having any more children, in order that their beautiful appearance might not fade. And the Lord caused the waters of the river Gihon to overwhelm them, and he destroyed and consumed them, and he destroyed the third part of the earth. But still, the sons of men did not turn from their evil ways, and yet they continued to do evil in the sight of the Lord. And Enosh had a son, Cainan, and he grew up and became wise and had knowledge and skill in all wisdom. And he reigned over all the sons of men, and he led the sons of men to wisdom and knowledge. For Cainan was a very wise man and had understanding in all wisdom. And with his wisdom, he ruled over spirits and demons. And Cainan knew by his wisdom that God would destroy the sons of men from having sinned upon the earth, and that the Lord would in the latter days bring upon them the waters of the flood. And in those days Cainan wrote upon tablets of stone what was to take place in time to come, and he put them in his treasures.